There we go. 33.1%, a little bit above the consensus of 32.0% on an annualized basis. However, the thing to keep in mind here with GDP is that the economy is not an annualized economy. It's a quarterly economy. It shrank by 10.1% in the first and second quarters together. So at 33.1%, we're looking at a 7.4% gain. So we're still in the hole by about 3%. The economy is still 3% smaller than it was at the beginning of the year.
Right.
We're looking for the breakdowns, but they haven't crossed yet. We're just waiting to see what kind of numbers we get out of that. But as has been pointed out many times, this is the largest quarterly increase in GDP ever, but it followed the biggest quarterly contraction in GDP.
Okay,
ever.
Mike, you know, for the sophisticates that are out there that aren't up to speed like you as an expert, down we go big. This is the report of up we go big. Where are we on level right now, Mike? How far beneath the level trend that we had in February are we?
Well, I think you got to go back to January, Tom, because in the first quarter, the economy did shrink by 5%. And so at this point, we are still, well, if at 33% is 7.4%, we were down 10.1. So you've got 2.7% smaller than we were coming into the year. Now, something else you want to keep in mind is that the economy continues to grow. And if we had grown at the same rate that we would have in 2019, an average of about 2.3% per quarter, you would have ended up with about a 65% annualized gain to try to make that up. So we're still well below where we would have been otherwise. That's about 3.6% more than otherwise we had gotten.
Mike, after these numbers, given the fact that they are better than expected pretty much across the board, you are seeing a little bit of a lift in futures, but not much. They're not really doing anything. What's more interesting to me is you're actually seeing Treasury yields bounce back. They had dipped a little bit, and now they are back up on the day. What leading indicator can we take from this data, given the fact that, as John rightly pointed out, the GDP figures, I will get my words out, are ancient history, and the jobless figures are similar, actually, at this point, given how fast the virus is moving?
Yeah, I think you make a couple of good points there, especially with the jobless claims figures. With the virus moving quickly, we're going to see additional targeted lockdowns, probably not something like we saw in Germany and France, but that probably means more people start to lose their jobs. It's also, if you've noticed outside, getting colder in New York and Boston and places like that. So we are going to see some of those restaurants that were open start to close up, and that's going to mean more jobless claims. And even if you don't agree with the level of claims, the actual number itself, the trend has been very flat. We're not seeing a lot of people going off that. We're still seeing a lot of new claims. Now, we do have some new numbers out, some of the breakdown coming out for the GDP numbers. Personal consumption was up 40.7% after falling 33.2% in the first quarter. And we're looking at the GDP price index up 3.6%. That was expected given the shortages of goods and the problems that we've had, but that's going to go down. People aren't going to look a whole lot at that. Now we've got a good breakdown of the numbers coming out here, and I can tell you that non-residential fixed investment, the business spending number, 20.3% after declining 27.2%. Right. So businesses not coming back quite as much as they lost. Personal consumption more than we lost. But again, remember the way this works, and Tom will tell you all about the math, that when you're coming from a lower base, the percentage change isn't as big. Government, we wanted to see this, down 4.5%. Of federal government spending was down 6.2% last quarter after rising 16.4% in the second quarter. That's the end of the PPP, and the small business loans goes away from federal spending. State and local government down 3.3% after a 5.4% decline, and that just shows you the hole gets bigger for state and local governments, the spending that they've had to do.
John Farrell, what's fascinating about this is how does Vice President Biden and President Trump, how do they campaign on a 33% lift in GDP? That's original American history.
They don't tell you it's annualized. That's how you campaign on that number, Tom Keene. You just don't tell anybody it's annualized, and you say it's set to continue.
We delivered a 33% economy.
Yeah, you know how it's going to go. You know how it's going to go. Mike, just to finish there, just a final point, if you can. the tailwind that we got from the fiscal package, the consumption numbers that we see right here, can you walk us through how much is left in the tank now so many, if not all, of those programs have expired?
Well, we do have some significant savings still out there, but people are spending them down. And the spending numbers so far seem to suggest that we have definitely seen a slowdown. If you look at the GDP by a month-to-month basis, it was very big in May and June and then has started to tail off. And August, September were much slower. And October looks to be the same story. So at this point, the consensus has been for about 3 to 4% growth in the fourth quarter as opposed, and that's on an annualized basis, as opposed to this 33.1%. So a significant slowing in the fourth quarter. And I think what you want to look at, perhaps to answer Lisa's earlier question, is the level of GDP at this point is higher than it was, but not still up to where we were. So it's going to be a question for the next president to figure out how to get us back to where we started from.